Yeah. The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep these haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep them haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips.
Paper chasing tight, got these niggas overlap. 20 toes, drop them off, then I hit the trap. Never nap, it's on my lap when I'm creeping through. Peekaboo, leave him shocked just like Pikachu. Hit him up top, now the nigga can't see his roof. Bitch, I'm up top chillin', you should see the view. Free all my niggas in the system, try and see it through. I told my mama we gon' make it, just me and you. True story, ain't no glory in this gutter, nigga. Growing up grimy, mama always suffering, nigga. Finding dope packs, brother always hustling, nigga. Daddy was never there, just like a buster, nigga. Ain't nothing usual, every week a funeral. Box you like a cubicle, gunpowder cuticles. Damn, my bitch is beautiful, got all different colors. I send them out of state, suitcase full of rubbers.
The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep these haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep them haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep my focus on them chips.
My snow bunny hit for like 10 out the Caesar's Palace. Tryna gain some weight, potato steak and a Caesar salad. I swear the money make me do it, nigga. The way I hit the scene make the people wanna sue me. Who the fuck think you foolin'? Got a chopper with a cooler. All this gold around my neck, bitch. I'm thinking I'm Rick the Ruler. Knick knack, patty whack, Swiss cheese, a Cadillac, Big Mac, all black. Sat him on his ass, cracked the wood hella big. Started coughing after pass that. Ride through the fast track, I just picked up a fast stack. My daughter called me like, daddy, I need them new J's. I'm Kanye the way I'm rhyme with these 2K's. Ayy, spent $100,000, but I'ma get it back. Shot him in his head, it ain't no getting back. The way a nigga moving with this stick, it's ridiculous. I slide to the neck, cause I ain't tryna have no witnesses.
The way a nigga moving be legit. Tryna keep these haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep them haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep these haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips. The way a nigga move it be legit. Tryna keep them haters out my shit. Man, you know them bitches on our dick. But I'm just tryna keep me focused on them chips.
That was D-Lo, The Way I Move, and I'm high as fuck, reading this story about a duck that was sucked 200 feet down into the Lake Berryessa Glory Hole. First off, I don't know why that's the term for it. It's like I don't know what the fuck it is. It's basically like a big ass hole in the lake where the water just goes down into wherever the fuck it goes. I don't know, but it goes like 200 feet down and shit. And yeah, they call it a fucking glory hole. I had to stop. I was scrolling through Facebook and I had to stop just because I saw the word sucked in glory hole. And I was like, what the fuck is the news saying? Like, damn, man. I don't know, but I had, we did. Me and a couple of homies, we were going up and down the West Coast. We went to a couple of spots out in Southern Oregon. Up there, fucking Southern Oregon out in, I think it was Medford. We went out to Medford for a while. We were doing a show at this club called Rumors. We had a Tupac impersonator coming through. It was going to be a big-ass Tupac tribute show and shit. So the Tupac impersonator's there with his girl. We're going to the hotel. We pass by. There's like a Winco, and then a smoke shop, and a fucking weed shop, and way tucked in the back in like this little industrial area is an adult store with a big-ass sign that says Video Arcade. And he's like, oh, that's those rooms you go in and you can watch the movies and shit. And then they had a light-up part that said couples. He's like, oh, they have couples rooms. So him and his lady want to go in there and get freaky in the couples room in the Video Arcade for some reason that's covered in jizz by other people who just watch porno in there. So I was like, whatever, y'all go in there. And I'm thinking, you know, Oregon's a weird place to go into an adult store because they got a lot of different people out there. There's lots of transsexuals and everything else. Like, they got the trannies, they got the gays, the lesbians. They have all new sorts of things I haven't even heard of before, probably. Like, they're on some weirdo shit out there. So he goes in, about 5 minutes later, they come out and they're freaked the fuck out. I said, what happened? Him and the lady get in there. They put the money in the machine. And for you guys don't know, they're these little ass booths and shit, and they're all next to each other. They're like the size of a fucking porta potty. And you go in there, there's like a bench and a screen that's got a protective fucking screen over it, and it's usually covered in semen everywhere. And you put the money in, and then you can like scroll through a list of just select DVDs they have playing, and they're like a movie theater kind of. And these ones had the double size that were for couples, so they're in there. They put the money in, they put the movie on, they start getting freaky. And he feels a presence of something. He's like, what the fuck? And he turns around, there's a dick hanging out the wall. And he's like, oh, it's gotta be a dildo or something. And he smacks it. Dude's like, oh. And he fucking pulled his dick out. Oh, he was like, oh, hell fucking no. And they ran the fuck out of there. That's horrible. If I'm ever in anywhere watching a movie of any type, I don't give a fuck if I'm at the movie theater watching Finding Nemo, and I look over and there's a dick next to my face, I'm beating the hell out of someone. I'm beating the fucking brakes off you. Just know that. I don't care if the hole is there or not. That's why I'm afraid to use public restrooms. Some real shit. But we're going to get into this track by Ritz called Lonely. Check it out.
Left Atlanta, drove from Boston to Los Angeles. Somewhere in between, I lost my mind like I began to just party like I'm trying to die. Call an ambulance, I almost overdosed again. My time is mostly spent alone inside this room, I'm messing shit emotive in. There's roaches in the shower, but the show was in an hour. When it's over, we'll be inside the van on the road again. Last night, I got so drunk that I was comatose, I went. Punched a bunch of holes up in the ball and broke my hand. Puking blood from too much slick, the trip is snorting coke with fans. One of my closest friends called my phone and asked me how's it been. Told him, man, I've been
out on the road so long, yeah. I feel like I'm locked out my own life. It could be worse, it ain't like I'm dying. Lonely is what company. Can't wait to get home and relax, but I'm out here grinding.
Over tech, I had to catch a plane to Hollywood. Mansion in the hills, shooting switch lanes, animated. Can't believe it's real. Right in the middle of us filming, got some texts from my girl. Pictures of a bloody face. She slid her wrist and fell. Pills in the system. Doctor said she tried to kill herself. Put her in a padded room, sent her to a mental health facility. They telling me that they won't let her out. 1,000 miles away, there's only so much I can do to help. Now my album's coming out in like a week or so. My videos on MTV deliver. My life is stuck in Georgia region. No, they let her use the phone. She called me and yeah, she's crying, saying, get me out, I'm trying. At the meet and greet, I'm lying like I'm fine. I've been dying.
Been out on the road so long, now I feel like I'm locked out my whole life. It could be worse, it ain't like I'm dying. Lonely is what company. Can't wait to get home and relax, but I'm out here grinding for leading. It could be worse, but the fact remains that lonely is what company.
I've been out on tour, it's snowing.
and Jaron Benton. It's so embarrassing when you drunk and acting dumb. A ton of strangers there to witness. Late nights with DJ Crisis, getting drunk and talking business. In the winter, overheating, turning on the air condition. Mostly, I was lonely, talking, no one there to listen. Crying in the mirror, staring at my own reflection. Drugs and alcohol got me all emotional, overwrought. I'm in no condition to battle my own addiction. Before you know it, though, the tour is over, so it's history. Missing Thanksgiving Day, but hey, you made it home for Christmas. You see the one you love and try to pick up where you left it. I love her and I missed her, but she say I'm at the distance. Told her, listen, I've been
out on the road so long.
Song speaks on some real shit, man. Like, a lot of people don't realize coming up in this industry and shit, it's not just what you see from the outside, all the glitz and glamour and shit like that. There's a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of fucking stress. This shit gonna put a strain on every fucking relationship you have, on some real shit. Like, you can't have a steady relationship with this shit. I mean, you can, but it's gonna be hard as fuck. Y'all gonna be crazy as shit by the end of it. And a lot of us in this industry, we're not as happy as we look. We're all just filling a void, you know? I mean, everyone's filling a void, I guess, but that's what we do. We fill the void with fame and money and motherfucking whatever else comes along with it, all the perks of it. But at the end of the day, man, you still got that empty feeling inside. You gotta make sure you work on you, man. That's why, I understand a lot of, like, the shit that Jim Carrey says and shit. And a lot of why he went fucking crazy and had to go find himself and grew a beard and just, like, doesn't leave his house anymore. This shit will do that to you. That's why we got people like Dave Chappelle going crazy, going to fucking Africa and shit, just disappearing on motherfuckers. Fucking... got Martin Lawrence out there running around with guns and shit. Because this fucking shit gets stressful as fuck, especially in the beginning stages when you first start reaching that fucking peak of fame. I mean, it's worth it. Just know what you're getting into, you know what I mean? But with that being said, we're going to get into some Brother Lynch Hung. Shout out to the original Black Market Records. Shout out to Made Sick Music, Homegirl Zigzag, Brother Lynch, everyone out there in Sacramento. We're going to get into some Brother Lynch Hung, Liquor Sick. Check it out.
So what really happened, nigga? I understand ain't nobody did shit. Ain't nobody did shit for my cousin. Where them niggas at that said they put it all on the line? Cause nigga, only a child could empty a gun toward the sky. I gotta know where niggas' heads at. Cause my cousin still ain't got no peace yet. So all you motherfuckers wanna know where I stand? Nigga, I stand right next to my cousin Emil, nigga. You know what I'm saying? And that's on the block, nigga. However you wanna handle this shit, nigga.
Look up in the sky, it's a motherfucking slug. Some nigga done let one off and only my cousin shedding blood. That locust motherfucker from 29th Street throwing up his flag. Some nigga got mad and went to the crib for the 44 mag. Returned to the setup and let my cousin have it. The nigga that died for the Garden Block gang did time for the Garden Block and ended up stuck in a motherfucking casket. But I don't be giving a fuck, I'm tapping up in your program. Before you know it, I'm creeping up on you in a licorice dark black drop top Rohan. With a 12-gauge pump in a trunk and a clip full of funk and a fat purple Kush blunt. So call it what you want, I call it the fever of the funk house. Dumping gauge shells in that ass, leaving your face down, chest down with a gang of guts hanging out your ass. Nigga, you know the process, they wanna kill me now. I'm a dead man walking to my funeral, can you feel me now? And if I die before your set gets blasted, that's on the gardens, I'ma rise up out my casket.
I'm liquor sick and I just might lose control.